You're listening to the Kisetsu-en seasonal podcast with Morten Albek. In this episode, I would like to talk about bonsai and age versus bonsai and use. We are taught for years that bonsai have to be about old trees, and it is so. It is something we have adapted from the Japanese bonsai culture. We also see it in the West. We like old buildings, we like antiques, we like to watch old trees in nature. They have this majestic feeling over them. They express something everlasting, something almost immortal. That we also learn from the Japanese art of bonsai, and I think most of us have been fascinated by looking at those old trees and pots standing there year by year, maybe being handed over from one family member to another, or at least sold and carried on through generations. I watched an old Japanese white pine, a cascade style white pine, designed by Tomio Yamada at the Sabi-en in Japan. It is a tree that is taking over generation after generation. He took it over from his father, and his daughter is now taking it over from him. It is designed like with a vision of a cascade style bonsai waterfall. So you can imagine the waterfall in the foliage patch dropping at this old white pine being more than 300 years old, and of course that is fascinating. We also learn about wabi-sabi, the expression of age, and compared with youth, that can be deadwood at an old tree. It can be the gnarled branches covered by fresh foliage. This we see in all kinds of Japanese bonsai, and it is important to express this kind of age. But why is it so important, and how has this evolved? Part of the answer can be found in the history of bonsai. Chinese Taoists began cultivating trees in pots more than 2,000 years ago. They understood that nature possesses those powerful forces, magical living qualities that you can find everywhere in nature, in trees, rocks, and even mountains. Old gnarled trees, according to the Taoists, represent the aged bodies of immortals. If you can hear something beside me, it's a younger thing, it's a cat who wants to pet a little. The aged bodies of immortals is the foundation of bonsai because they are closely linked to these qualities of age and magical power. Today's Western bonsai enthusiasts come from very different backgrounds than ancient Chinese Taoists. Even so, communicating age is of a prime importance. A young tree is never as fascinating as an old tree, or is it? Most of the trees that we see in ancient and contemporary art are old and dignified. Maybe humans are humbled by the nature expressed in old trees, which outlive us many times over. Even bonsai will live for many generations if they are well cared for and treated with the deepest respect. If we look at the Japanese concept of wabi-sabi, that comes from the tea ceremony developed by Zen no Rikui more than 400 years ago. Briefly said, wabi-sabi understands beauty to be imperfect, impermanent, and incomplete. Nothing is perfect, nothing lasts forever, nothing is ever really complete. Taken individually, wabi implies simplicity and freshness, while the sabi has to do with age, the wear and tear, and resultant beauty that develop over time. Wabi-sabi is a key concept in the art of bonsai as we know it. It is also important in Japanese gardening as well as other Japanese art forms. maybe we cannot fully understand it in the West, because there are meanings and expressions within wabi-sabi that is purely linked to the Japanese culture. But if we take a look at the imperfectness thing and look at old furnitures, antiques, it can be an old table or chair, whatever, and we appreciate the age when it is not worn out and destroyed and is broken, but it still stands there as something steady and sturdy, but with the marks of the age. We still appreciate that in many forms, in furnitures, in buildings. It can be old mechanics that fascinates us with their beauty of age. It can be an old leather jacket worn by a man for several years, and it is still fully functional, but you can see the leather is used and soft, but has its own beauty. It can be all kinds of things. So if we want to try to understand the wabi-sabi concept to succeed that in bonsai, that doesn't mean you should neglect your own heritage. Cultural values or personal expressions, we just have to try to bring some of that in if we want that in the aging of old bonsai. But we can also try to do it a different way, maybe. Looking at young trees, why shouldn't we be able to find some of the same values without being exactly the same, of course, because we now neglect some of the age, and look at the youth and freshness put into a bonsai style that shows something that is new and not old, but still have some of the simplicity and imperfectness and naturalness that we appreciate in bonsai. Contrived perfection will never do. Branches arranged like the spokes of a wheel are not wabi-sabi. It is not bonsai and should be avoided. Everything has to be a little imperfect, with maybe a crossing root, different lengths of branches, and uneven spaces between branches and the items we use for bonsai. You could call wabi-sabi an intuitive appreciation of the transient beauty of the physical world. There is a bittersweet quality that exists in a modest, rustique, imperfect, or even decayed item that communicates the impermanence of all things. And that, I think, we can also put into a younger expression of bonsai. If we take a young Korean hornbeam, put it in a bowl, in a pot, add some mosses, a little fern, some grasses, or some shrub that carries berries, and mix that, we will have a impression of a forest piece. Could be at a riverbed, could be nearby a lake, or just in the light play between trees. And this young feeling that doesn't throw away the importance of age can still be, I think, a bonsai expression of great value, adding something to the palette of how we look at bonsai. If we do not seek just some kind of new expressions or variations of what has been for so long a time, we will never develop anything, and it might in the Western world be a little boring at some time if we just keep repeating and repeating and not renewing. If we put a piece together with this Korean hornbeam, a young piece with light branches without that age structure and well pruned ramification, but just keep it as a simple and young tree with those plantings at the ground and a pot that fits, it will look different than the old tree, of course. But it has its own full potential in showing that freshness in the forest, and mixed with, when I record this, the autumn feeling with the yellow and reddish hornbeam leaves that begins to drop. We get that wabi-sabi feeling even from this young spitzy. This is maybe a short moment of appreciating this piece, but it will be the same if you take the Japanese apricot, the Prunus mumma, that only flowers one time at the year in the late winter months without leaves popping out yet. We have those old gnarled branches and these fresh, new, beautiful flowers. It only lasts for a moment, and the rest of the year it's about keeping the tree healthy and waiting for the next flowering. The same with the young specimen here. If we can hit that feeling in just a moment, I think that is worth it. Of course, the freshness is different in spring when the leaves pops out and everything begins to grow, but I think there is a place for youth in bonsai as well as age, if we just take care of not just being sloppy and putting something together just to do it. You will see the same freshness in the kusamono and the shiatsukusa, the accent plantings, and the groupings of shrubs that will still have this feeling of a kind of age and freshness blending together if they have settled well. I have to remember that this is not just an instant creation that will be fully developed in a season, as everything in bonsai, also that kind of composition, have to blend in and grow well together. We do that with shiatsukusa and kusamono as well. We group them, and after 2 or 3 years they will have settled in. There will be a lot of material available, simple material, collected seedlings that can be grown as such. I at a time saw some seedlings of pines with only the extending needles at the ends grouped like a small forest in a Shohin or marmosized in a primitive small rock pot, and it looked fabulous. It really had this young feeling, and at the same time it also looked quite old. So it is very much up to the artist to express and the audience to be able to see it and adapt that into their mind. To add some of that aged feeling to the young spitzy here, the Korean hornbeam with the fresh young leaves and branches, we can add something else to the display of this piece. We can put it on an old wooden box, a burnt piece of wood that adds the wabi-sabi feeling, the old and worn out, contrasting to the fresh and the new. So instead of having the old tree add something new, we can add something young to something old, just swapping the meaning of things, swapping the items, so we keep that feeling of an immortal thing, giving it a new expressing with the young tree. So let's play and do something that is not just the ordinary copy and paste from what we see in magazines and videos and what we are told to do all the time. Try to think in a new way. Just changing things and the meaning of them can mean a lot if bonsai shall become an art form that stays. We have to develop it. It is far easier to take an old tree, not that it is easy to make an old tree, that takes a lot of years and time and skills and efforts, but it is easier to express the age through an old tree and not when you're using younger trees. So when we are digging into Shohin bonsai, instead of looking at the bigger, older, thick trunk bonsai that we love and appreciate, if we look into Shohin bonsai, we also have that expressing of something that is younger, even when we are designing our junipers or our maples with fat small trunks. We will still not have that totally everlasting image of an old tree as we have with larger bonsai. There is a difference, and with Shohin bonsai we also try to show the changing of the seasons much more than we are showing the age of the individual tree. It is a little bit more light field and with a lighter feeling and not so mature an expression. We can use old furniture, racks to underline that. We can use pots that are antique and expressing the age this way, but we can also do something else when we are using younger trees and that freshness in display. We can use burnt wood. An old apple box I have used at a time to set up a Shohin bonsai display that gave a total different feeling. We can experiment with that sort of things. It could also just be an old piece of wood, arranging it a little different, maybe in a kind of a more modern way. Age doesn't have to just be something that is expressed by the tree alone. It is the full image of the items we bring together that gives that contrast between something young and fresh and something old. One of the interesting things about age versus youth is to look at an old bonsai and then compare it to a new. I'm standing in my bonsai garden and look at a quite old Japanese maple I have trained for plus 20 years now. It is not in place anywhere yet. I still have to develop branches. I still have to mature the trunk, make it thicken up. But the age it has in this case is much about the history of the tree. It also have significance in my life, how long time I have grown these trees, and that is why I not yet are willing to sell my bonsai. I want my life to be with these trees and let them age with me. Of course, until a certain point when I get old and cannot take care of them anymore, and maybe I will skip some trees before then because the collection will be too big and also need to enjoy the trees. But the age of this Japanese maple, it started as a young ordinary nursery school material, not thicker than my little finger. Now it is maybe 5 centimeters wide when you measure it from one side to another, in diameter 5 to 6 centimeters maybe. Not very much up the trunk and wider at the base. The bark begins to show some age. It has changed from having that young, fresh, light green bark, now getting brown with the variety having red branches at the ends. Leaves beginning to turn the color and soon the leaves will begin to drop. The branches are arranged so some of them are pointing a little downwards. It is a deciduous tree and it is most natural that the branches grow a little down, shaded from the top, and then the top branches are grown more upwards. That is what recognizes a deciduous tree, where a coniferous tree will have most of the branches dropping because snow and wind and ice will force the branches down as well as they are shading them down, so they sink down and outwards, but especially pressured down by snow. Although the tree is not yet that old to look at, it has a history with me and I look at it differently than at a tree that I get as a young spitzy just coming in the door and then begin to train it. The history of a tree also has something to do with age because you follow the tree on the way. Just beside this, there is a classical shaped Japanese satsuki or satsuki azalea with beautiful old nebari surface roots spreading from the base. There's a really thick trunk. It tapers beautiful up to the top of the tree. The branches are beginning to mature and bark is also beginning to look older at this spitzy from the inner branches to the outer branches and from the trunk and upwards. At other trees the bark is clearly older and getting flaky and gnarled. For example, at a old hawthorn, also a tree I have had for many years, here the bark is really old to look at, and at junipers it might be the deadwood that adds this kind of age. And here the tree itself doesn't have to be very old to show that age because we can add it when adding deadwood as an artistic feature. When we turn our eyes to the pot, it is also part of the expression of age. Older pots with patina often are much more beautiful than young and fresh pots just thrown from the kiln and put on the bench and added a tree. Older pots will wear that dirt from the air, from the fertilizer, from the watering, and the environment also influence on how the pots looks. As we talked about old furnitures or an old leather jacket, with time, age will begin to be expressed even on a dead material. As a pot, it still is alive somehow. Bonsai is art, and we need to try to express it in different ways, seek maybe new directions. Maybe we are just changing a little on something we have seen before. But if bonsai is art, we also have to develop it and explore what is possible. And I think the youth and the young easily can be blended in with the old and the aged. Thank you for listening to this podcast from Kisetsu-en, our seasonal podcast with Morten Albek. I thank you for listening.